on, and today we're going to look at something a little bit different than some stuff we've looked at in the past. I was watching some videos of another channel on YouTube recently and saw them using something that I immediately said, you know what, I need one of those myself. And what that was just a USB LED. In fact, I've got a couple of them here that I purchased on Amazon, and these are Lipcitine brand, Lipcitine, and I got 7 colors for $8.99. They also sell them in a couple of different packs that are like $6.99 for 4, but all 4 are the same color. So per volume, this is the better deal, but if you just wanted, you know, red ones or white ones, you're going to pay a little more, but you get all 4 that are the same. This has got 7 different colors, and really, they're pretty dead simple. We're just going to go ahead and get right into it. So that's it. They're just little USB plugs that have an LED on them. And the purpose that I bought these for was to use them as a power draw that's not one of my more expensive devices, when I just want to check that something USB is actually outputting power. What I mean by that is if I've got a power bank that I'm testing or reviewing, and I just want to, you know, first up make sure that it works and spits out 5 volts, I can plug my charge doctor into it and I can throw one of these on it and see, yes, I'm not going to send 14 volts into my camera that is a 5-volt device. My phone quick charge throws a whole separate wrench in the works there. But it, at least for just basic 5-volt, these are fine. What they were actually billed for on Amazon is they show them being used in automotive applications for lighting up a car interior. You'd plug them in a USB port under your center console if you've got one, so that, you know, you could see change or other things that you'd end up accumulating there over time. So, without drawing things out too much, we're just going to grab one of these at random. And I've got, I mentioned earlier, my charge doctor here, and I'm going to plug it in. And it looks like we're pulling 5.14 volts and a massive 0.03 amps. So not a whole ton of power draw. You can see that they're bright-ish. They're not super bright. Let me kill my studio. Well, let's find the white one, and then we'll do, actually, instead of that, this will look familiar. This was from my Aurico USB hub video. And I'm hoping that if I plug in its power leg and plug that into the charge doctor. All right, the light in the, that's funny, it pulls the same 0.3 amps that these do. The light in my hub came on, so let's see. So we've got, red, G, we'll go with blue, and I don't really think this is indigo, but it's teal. And we'll put them all in the right order, just to make people happy. And attached to this hub, with all 7, we're still pulling 5 volts, and it looks like we're pulling a massive 0.1 amp. So, that's not too terrible. They're not drawing a ton of power. Let's kill some of my studio lights, so that we can see just how bright they really are. Or aren't, as it may be. You can see that They're, you know, nice. They'd do as an accent behind a monitor or something like that, if that was the type of thing that appealed to you. But, you know what, if I try and light up, I don't know, a ruler here, they're not going to act as a flashlight. They're not something that you're going to use to replace that. Like I said, I just bought them so that I have some kind of load that I can throw into things as a basic functionality test. You know, I can throw these into there. There's a couple of places I could see using them. You know, my server, my desktop, they've got USB ports. On the motherboard, I could see throwing a couple of white ones on there just for some interior case illumination. Because sometimes you have to work on the server while it's running. And a little bit of extra lighting never hurts. Beyond that, you know, behind a monitor, they might make an ace accent there. I know they make RGB strips. I might consider throwing, I don't know, maybe the blue one in my monitor's USB hub just so I can see the ports underneath the bottom of it when I'm plugging things in. Beyond that, all in all, you know, not bad. Probably a little more expensive they should have been. A little bit of digging around on eBay might turn up something similar for less than, what did I say? I got 7 of these for $8.99. Yeah, so I got 7 for $8.99, which makes them just a bit over $1 and change per LED. I wouldn't feel terrible if I saw one of these at the dollar store and bought it, but I'd feel better about if it was, you know, a 2-pack or something. So that's all there is to them. They're just little USB LEDs. Kind of fun, nifty little colors. I'm sure if you grab one for, you know, a kid or something to plug into their power bank or their laptop or whatnot, they'll be happy enough. And I could see a couple of little auxiliary uses where you've got a USB port and just need a little more light in the general area. So they're fairly well built. They're just a piece of plastic wrapped around a lens, and there's a little board in there that I'm sure if I look, I just have a resistor and two diodes crossing the power lines on USB. Power draw, not really a huge deal. This isn't even a particularly large bank that I used. I don't even know if this outputs a full 2.1. Yeah, output 5 volt DC, 1 milliamp per port. So I guess you could build a nightlight out of one. Would be another nifty application for that kind of thing. You know, take an old USB power adapter that, you know, can't feed a modern device. This is just a 5 volt 1 amp brick from a Chromecast audio, I think. And throw one of these in here and hey, look, now it's a nightlight. So all in all, nifty things. There's not much to say. You plug them in, they work. So that's all there is. Thank you for taking a couple of minutes to watch this. I want to go ahead and thank Electrix for providing our opening and closing music. I also want to go ahead and thank any of our patrons. If you like seeing, you know, little things like this or some of our more in-depth videos, definitely go ahead and think about subscribing. If you've got any questions about these or, you know, have suggestions of, hey, here's another little USB doodad we'd like to see, go ahead and leave them in the comments below.